What's going on, everybody? My name is DJ Carlo Atendido, and welcome to a very special live stream. It's actually my first live stream, and in this live stream, we're gonna work with Serato Studio and make a dope beat with a very popular song you may already know. So to help me do just that, or rather, to help us do just that, we have the master of Serato Studio, Matt Perry. Matt, would you kindly introduce yourself to our wonderful crowd that we've gathered today?
What's up, everybody? Hi, my name is Matt. Thank you very much to Carlo for having me on today. Today, we're going to talk about using Serato Studio and making a re-drum of one of Carlo's favorite songs.
And since this is going to be a live stream, feel free, guys, to like comment down below what you feel or if you have any questions, because we have Serato Studio ninjas just in the chat ready to help you out. And yeah, let's hear the beat we're going to break down.
Let me share my screen with you guys so you can all see. Awesome.
Oh, sorry. Before we proceed, guys, Serato Studio is free to download. Use my coupon code down below. And I think there's actually a Black Friday sale going on. So now is the time to get Serato Studio, and now's the time to learn. Okay, Matt, proceed on.
All right, so this is the song September by Earth, Wind & Fire. And this is how it sounds now. And there we have it, the quick taste of what we're going to be able to make with Serato Studio today.
All right, so the song is September by Earth, Wind & Fire, and I actually chose this song because it's a very fun song. Everyone knows it, everyone just dances to it, and I actually asked Matt to actually make this re-drum for us. So now that you know the song, let's proceed to deconstructing it.
All right, so I'm going to open up a new project from Template, and we're going to choose New Remix. Today we're not going to make a beat, we're going to do a new remix. So I'm going to click new remix, and once I've done that, it's going to take me to this area here where it wants me to drop a song. So I'm going to go to my Serato DJ library, because I use Serato DJ to DJ with, and it's already got all my crates and all my songs in it already. If you don't use Serato and you just get into this software, you can just drag any file from your desktop or any folder right into this area. But I'm going to search in my Serato DJ library for September. Mm-hmm. As you can see, when you click on it, it gives you a preview of the song. And I can just drag that up to the audio area here. And there we are. There it goes. It's in there. This is the big waveform that you see. And then below, this is where you see you're going to arrange it. So you can move this around if you need to. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to delete that right now. And I'm going to pull in new cue points. So this one is a clip, and I can drag that into the timeline, but I don't want to do that. I want to actually take the cue points from my Serato DJ cue points that I've already set. So I just click from this drop-down menu here for Serato DJ, and then I click the Serato DJ button, and there they are.
Oh.
Already there in the song there for me. And what's even better is that the first song that I've dragged into the Serato Studio, it's already figured out the key and the BPM of the project. So you'll see up here, this is the project BPM, 116 beats per minute, and the key is A major. So if I go back to my library here, you'll see that the song BPM is 117 or pretty close, and A major is the key. And so I don't have to worry about changing that. It's already automatically synced that up for me right out the gate, which is quite a unique thing about Serato Studio when you compare it to other DAWs.
Nice.
Cool. So now that I'm back here, I'll go back to my song view. I want to add another element, and I'm going to add the acapella. I want to work with the acapella as well. So I'll just click and drag that into this area here. There we go. Go back to my song view. And now you see I've got the acapella in here. I'm going to rename this so I know that that's what it is, acapella. And this one is the track.
Nice. So Matt, like one of a pretty common question I get is like, where do people or where do professional DJs get their acapellas and instrumentals? So I want to get your take on this and I want you to be honest.
Yeah, sure. I mean, there's lots of places you can get them from. I've got this. This one is, I don't actually know where I got this one. I think I might have been given it, but I get them from a variety of different places. I have a vinyl collection, which I started out DJing with, that has acapellas on it. And then I also get them from record pools like BPM Supreme, DJ City, Live DJ Service, DigiWax. And then there's even a website that I use sometimes called acapellasforyou.co.uk. And you can download some from there as well. Where do you get your acapellas from?
Well, I get my acapellas and instrumentals and sometimes my songs from YouTube. I actually rip music. And here's a quick nugget of wisdom for you. My freestyle set in Azerbaijan, where we met Matt, was actually all ripped from YouTube.
Wow. Yeah. That's crazy. It was a great set too.
Thank you. But nobody noticed the sound quality. So guys, don't let YouTube ripping stop you, but always go for the better quality stuff. Like this acapella sounds great, man.
All right. Well, let's get into this acapella actually. So that's the first thing we're going to chop up. And you can see here, I can drag my my mouse along here and find the part that I want. This obviously starts off with a cue point here.
Bimba!
But I want to take the last outro part where they're singing the la-di-das. And that sounds, there we go. That's the spot. I'm just going to turn that down a bit. I'm going to get this white line right where I want it to be and set a cue point on it by just clicking two or the two on my keyboard. And that'll trigger it. And then I'm going to drag that into the timeline here by just clicking and dragging it down in there. Zoom out a bit. And I don't need the whole thing, so I can just crop that down. I only need, like this much. There we go. And if I want to zoom in, I can just make sure there's no nasty extra bits. Oh, like, yeah, looks all good. Mm-hmm. And then I'll duplicate that again.
And you use like Command D for that.
Thank you. Yeah, sorry. So if I undo that, you can select this and then just click Command D, or if you prefer, you can just drag it down and then you can edit it again if you want.
Cool.
I definitely find Command D is the fastest way to do that. Mm-hmm. And now we've got the acapella. Cool. So now we can start adding in the track. So I'm going to go back to the track. And I just want this first bit. And you'll see here, if I click the top, I can move this cue point around if I need to. And the bottom part, I can also drag out and it will highlight just a certain region that I need. So I only need like, let's just drag it out to there. But I only need like a small part of this. So I'm going to drag this down here. And then drag another one down. And it will all kind of snap to this grid here, which is really nice. And this part, let's just move that. I think I moved that cue point back a bit too far. There we go. need to drag in another part of the song. Which part is that part? So I'm going to right click and split to new clip, E. And so I don't need that bit. I just want this bit. So let's hear how that sounds together. Maybe I got a little bit too tight there, so move that back a little bit. There we go. Do you remember? And that's the part where I want to start. Cool. So you can kind of just chop up the song as you want. Maybe I'll do another one for the chorus. Yeah, right click, split to new clip. That's my chorus. So if I need to move these around, I can. And now I've got kind of like the structure of the intro sounding pretty good. Cool. So I've got my intro, a nice a cappella intro. I think you like the a cappella intros, right, Carlo?
Oh, yeah. They're super easy to use and they're flexible to use, especially when you're in a DJ set. Like, I personally would prefer using a cappella intros than like normal extended beats, because like you can actually like use those things for like a mashup, or you can even scratch them in. So having something like this is actually pretty useful.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, it already is kind of useful as just a DJ edit, but let's take it a step further. And to do that, I want to add my own drums. So we've been mainly working with these audio tracks here. And now when I click on this scenes area, it's going to take me into this part of the software. And this is where, you know, you can add drums, samples, or instruments. And by default, it comes up right now with a drum kit. Which you should be able to hear. And you can add these drums into this area here, which is a sequencer. And this is basically one bar, and it's broken up into these 16th notes. And you can just place, by clicking here, you can just paste in your drums. Or if you prefer, you can right click and fill in the row. I'm just going to do 1/4, so that's every four beats. Mm-hmm. Every quarter note, sorry.
Yeah.
Four on the floor on every beat. And then I'm going to add some claps. Actually, I'll just leave it like that right now. I want to make it longer, though. This is just one bar. I want to make it two bars, so that's eight beats. And you'll see here, this intro just got a bit bigger down here. And that's because we doubled the size. And this is where you add these sequences in. You can just drag them in like this and paste them and move them around and add them to the whole project. And the good thing is, as I said earlier, once it's determined the project tempo, this is going to play in time with that tempo. So when we play it in this area, it's already in time, so that's kind of cool. Now, if I want to add more elements to this scene, I can do it in the scene, or I can create copies, and then it will copy over the automation, and then I can add new things to this one. So I want to add claps to this one. So I'm just going to draw some claps in. So now this is the scene. This is the first scene, and this is the second scene. This one has claps. This one doesn't. Mm-hmm. And then on this one, I'm going to copy scene two again, and I'm going to add a sample on this one. And I'm going to add a sample from the drum, from my library, from my my audio samples. Mm-hmm. So I want to find a shaker.
Or just to liven things up.
Yeah, just to add like another element that I can add a lot, maybe in the chorus or something. So I'll throw the shaker in here. And this shaker, if I click here, it'll trigger it. But I want it to play longer than that, so I'm going to extend it out to play the whole sequence. And you'll notice this is also already in time. And you'll see here this shaker is actually originally at 100 beats per minute and in the key of E minor. But it's synced it to 116. And it's also tried to sync the key. I don't need the key to sync, though. So I'm going to turn the key sync off. But I do want the BPM to sync. So there we go. Nice. So that's good. Now we've got the intro. We got the drum beat, and then we've got a shaker. So let's rename this one to Shaker.
Shaker.
Cool. So now I can start adding these elements to the track. So let's hear how it goes from here. I want to start right there. Do you remember, with the drums, with the clap as well? And I'm just going to duplicate this a couple times. So I'm just going to press Command D.
So that's like our beat one, right?
Yep, the downbeat, exactly. So if we zoom in, let's hear how that sounds. Keep this going until the chorus. And add the shaker in here. Mm-hmm. Command D. Command D. Cool. So we're getting a pretty good idea of like how this is going to be structured. And you can see already there's like, you know, the verses, the choruses, the verse, the chorus, this intro part here. You're getting an idea for song structure at this point. And we should probably continue on. I'm going to assume that it's the same structure for this. So one, two, three. So that's four, maybe another four. And then after this point, maybe we get back into the chorus. Or does it... Okay, it comes in a little earlier. So that's a shorter verse. But this will continue on probably till the rest of the song.
Oh yeah, it'll fade out. Yeah.
Now you may be wondering, you know, this is all in time, like perfectly in time. And, you know, to be honest, this song, if you just threw it in and tried to do this yourself, you might have a little bit of issue because the song is played by a live band. And, you know, the tempo of that song may fluctuate as the drummer is playing live. And fortunately, I play the song in Serato DJ all the time. So I've actually set the beat grids on this. And I don't know if you guys are aware of beat grids, but on this song, I've already set the beat grids. And because I did it in Serato DJ, it also works in Serato Studio automatically, so I don't have to do it again. Mm. If you're wondering what beat grids are, if I just click on this little grid button here, you'll see these lines are here. And there's a red line that starts it. And then there's these white lines afterwards. And these will go continue throughout the song. Red lines kind of pop up every now and then. And that's when there's any kind of fluctuation in the tempo, I've set a red line to correct it. And that will, you know, basically quantize the song or speed it up and slow it down relative to the consistent tempo. So I've done that throughout the song already. So it's already syncing up with his drums. If you have to do it, you can set and adjust all of these parameters in here or in Serato DJ and it will be copied over.
Wow. Very powerful stuff.
Yeah, it's kind of one of the things that's a bit unique about, from what I understand about Serato software versus other DJ software, is that the way it works with live drums and live tracks is that you can really adjust the grids on these tracks so that they do work correctly and they do sync correctly. Mm-hmm. So I'm just going to, I don't need to edit those, they're already done. So that's I can cancel that. And now on this drum pattern here, I think this drum's just kind of okay. These are the stock sounds, but I would like to make the drums a bit more punchy. And I've definitely got a lot of drums because Serato does come with its own drum packs. You can see here, this is the core pack for free. You got all these whole drum kits, so I could drag a whole drum kit in here. Let's take the Club 909 kit.
Oh, it's completely different.
Yeah, exactly. And if I want to find just a kick drum, I can go search for just a kick in this, in here, and I can go through all my drums just like you would in Serato DJ. These are all my kick drums. And one pro tip that I've done just to take it a little bit further is I actually set up a smart crate of all my kicks. So the smart crate is this little purple button here. If you add a smart crate, you can create a smart crate that has rules, and all the songs in this crate will follow these rules. So I typically use one for file name and contains, you know, kick or something. And when I save that, that will pop up like this one here with all my kicks in it. So I can just easily find only kicks that I need when I need to find them. So let's go to Track Girl's drum kit. She's got great kicks.
Nice. And this comes at Serato Studio, right?
That's right. Yeah, if you have a Serato Studio license, you can download this for free. So we'll swap out that kick. And then I'm going to go looking for a clap from my clap smart crate. Pretty cool.
Oh wow, that sounds great.
Let me try a different kick. That one's pretty cool. There's so many kicks to use. Try this one. There we go.
Yeah, nailed it.
Sounds really pumping now. So let's hear how that sounds with the track. have just claps in this part, so I'm going to copy this one. And I want to do something here where I just throw this one in here as the claps. But what I want to do is I just want to turn the volume down on just the kick. So I could just delete this kick completely. But I'm going to do something a little bit later. So I'm just going to turn the volume down. And if I click on this little robot here, this will allow me to choose the whole kick or just the whole kit or just the kick. And I just want to change the volume of the kick. So I'm just going to turn the volume down on this scene, just the scene. So you'll see that everywhere else it's fine, but just the scene has the volume down. So I can turn that robot off. Do you remember when- and now I'm going to go back to my track and I'm going to show you guys a really cool trick that is very, very popular with people like Kate Renato, with Daft Punk, with any kind of major, you know, hip-hop or EDM producer. A lot of them are using this feature. It's called sidechain.
And I'm going to use the.
You've heard of that?
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's really easy to do in Serato Studio. It's one of the cool things about it. So if I open up the effects panel by clicking the effects, on the right side, I can apply an effect that'll affect the whole song. So I'm going to choose from the drop-down menu. I'm going to use hard sidechain. And I'm going to turn this up. This is the intensity of it. And if I just solo the song without the drums, you'll be able to hear it working.
It's like the drums disappeared.
Yeah, wait for this. So it kind of creates this pumping, like ducking effect, which is really, really effective, especially once you add the drums into the whole mix, because it really creates and carves out space for the drums to really come through. So let's hear how that sounds with everything together. And actually, let's put it on the acapella too. Let's throw that on the acapella. There we go.
Bouncy.
Yeah, kind of bouncy, right? Mm-hmm. Now I'm just going to remove the last clap on this scene because I want it to just come in. Do you remember? There we go. And now I can just make some changes to the scenes and I just like kind of change them up a little bit. So I'm going to make a copy of this one and I'm going to use the same automation technique where I just choose the whole drum kit and I just choose a mute option. So this will give me the ability to mute just the last part of the sequence. And I'll do that for the percussion as well. Oops, filter. We want mute. There we go. And that'll just kind of create some space for a turnaround.
Nice.
And you'll hear that, you know, it's always good to have these kind of things. So I'm going to create a copy of the main beat as well. Mm-hmm. Create a copy of that and do the same thing for that one. And we just have to do that on the drum kit because there's no shaker on this one. So we can add that in here. So maybe we'll put one here as well, just to turn around.
Yeah.
Now let's also speed up this whole track. It's a little slow at 116. Let's move it up to 122 and see how that sounds. Let's take it from the intro. Now, much more energy and energetic now.
Oh yeah, and that sidechain really, really does modernize the track.
It really does. Yeah, I like that a lot. And I think really the only other thing I really want to add to this now is some crashes. So I'm just going to add another audio track, and I'm going to go into my audio samples. Actually, I'll go to my drums, and I'll just go for a crash. Let's see what I got. That's a good one. Let's drag that in there. And I'm just going to turn the sync off on this one as well because it's a percussion element. It's not it hasn't really got a tone to it. Mm-hmm. Let's pitch it up a little bit. Also add a few more of these on the choruses. There. And here. And here. And here. Every four sequences probably should sound good. Mm-hmm. Music works in fours. Cool. And I'm going to turn that volume down for just the crash a little bit if it's a bit loud. And I'm going to do this really cool little trick that that I like to do where I just set a cue point and then I click the reverse button.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's a riser.
And it gives us a riser. Yeah. I'll throw that in there. And we'll just click that a little closer there. I'll put a little reverb on this too, just to make it sound a little brighter in the mix. Mm-hmm. Cool.
Mm-hmm. Sounds a lot better.
This cool, let's just move this back a bit. There we go. Now I think that's gonna feel a little bit better in time. There we go. Cool. And then I can just add like a few of those turnarounds to the rest of the automation of the song. And we're pretty much done, honestly.
Yeah. Sounds so alive.
Yeah. Is there anything else you think we need to add in here?
Oh, maybe let's probably implement the limiter on the master track.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's a good idea. Yeah. And I'm just going to make sure this is all good here. Yeah, I need another turnaround there. Cool. So yeah, let's go to this master channel here. So we click on master, and then you'll see this is where the whole track is, and you can see the whole waveform, which will be very familiar if you've ever used Serato DJ before. And you can adjust the volume of the master here if you need to. And then you can add the limiter, which is like a great way to bring it all together. So click on limiter and just turn that up a bit, and it'll kind of glue everything together. So let's listen to that. Maybe we'll just take it from here.
Okay.
That's kind of it. I mean, you can turn up the bass a little bit more or something, but let's just go to the master and then export that out. We'll export it as an MP3. We can do it as a wave if we want, depending on how much hard drive space we have remaining. And click export. Call this September Redrum.
Yeah.
And click save. And it exports pretty fast too. You can see it moving along.
Wow.
And then when you're done with that, you know, you can just like pull that right up onto your DJ library and play it right away. And it should sound pretty good. And you can have, you can see definitely like in the waveform down the bottom here, how it should look when you pull it up in your DJ software. So it should be very familiar. If you use Serato DJ, you'll know like the red means like more bass and then greens are more high end and stuff like that. So yeah, it'll look exactly like that when you pull it up in Serato DJ, if you use Serato DJ.
Nice. I mean, you should use Serato DJ. But yeah, like this whole process was so simple. Like all you had to do was like layer the original song with a cappella and then layer it with your new modern beat and decorate it. And that's it.
Yeah. I think just to wrap it up, I'd like to say that like, you know, if you're a DJ and you get into production, one of the good things and one of the benefits of Serato Studio is it's really designed for, you know, DJs to get into production because all this is laid out very much the same as, you know, a DJ controller. All the controls work if you have like a DDJ SB3 or a Mixtrack Pro or something like that, or a Roland 202. They all are mapped for this software, so you can just use it and you don't have to, you know, buy another piece of hardware just to get using, or you can just use it with your laptop. So yeah, I hope that's been helpful for you, Carlo, and for your audience.
Oh yeah. And I guess with that said, we've reached the end of our live stream. So thank you, Matt Perry, for joining me today. And thank you guys for watching. And yeah, please download Serato Studio. It's on sale. And use the coupon code down below. Bye, everybody. Thank you very much.